Welcome to early game Switchglaive build for Neo 2, you Grim Reaper role-playing bastards. Before we start with this build, I have to explain what early game means in Neo so there is no confusion. It means first playthrough more or less, not first couple of regions or levels. In this case it is for first 100 levels or so. Max character level is 750 and there are 4 more difficulties beyond starting one. And endgame content on top of that called Abyss and Depths. New difficulties unlock one after another by completing set number of missions. Early game builds that I'm doing are for first playthrough for the most part, and they change a bit as you progress due to better equipment becoming available over time. You can play with same exact gear however for many playthroughs as long as equipment level corresponds your own. That is done by soul matching gear at the blacksmith or acquiring smithing texts that allow crafting gear at your level with lower set requirements. For levels 50 and 60 builds are not really possible, at least not very effective ones. Up until then it is best to go for balanced stat distribution with additional points into magic in this case, but also make sure to match requirements of the armor set you plan on using. At around level 100 stats should look something like this. I am investing a bit more into constitution this time around to get last guardian spirit bonus which I am going to explain later. 16 points into skill is necessary for set that I'm wearing, but if you got smithing text for it, requirements are gonna be much lower. From level 100 onward, continue leveling magic, constitution, heart and courage. Set I opted for is Golden Gourd. It is fantastic set overall, but requires 7 pieces for all of its bonuses. Seething Dragon Switchglaive is ideal choice because of Imbue Corruption, which is amazing against humans. Versus Yokai, we apply Purification Talisman that overwrites Corruption, so we are sorted no matter who we are up against. Special effects should be focused around active skill stuff. Most important special effects on armor pieces are Life Recovery to Ramrita Absorption on chest piece and on Gauntlet's attack effect paired with one of the active skills damage increase. Path of the Tree and Kiboshi Kicker are the ones I would recommend. One of the accessories needs to be Tokichiro's Gourd and both need to have melee damage versus poisoned enemy effect. Before acquiring Golden Gourd set, I would recommend Shinto from first region with mandatory use of Sacred Water. After that, best fit would be Master Archer that focuses on lightning damage. Takenaka is good option too as well if you want more tanky playstyle. Best starting Guardian Spirit is Makami because of all around good bonuses. After that, stick with Usura Hicho up until Yumehami is unlocked. It has last effect called Ki Recovery through Amrita Absorption. This is great for this build, but it requires in this case heavy investment into constitution. At this point you won't have it active most likely, but continue investing into constitution to eventually unlock it. Before this Ki Recovery effect is unlocked, we use Sacred Water with Shinto to deal with that problem and afterwards Barrier Spell. Cores I'm using are Shoot and Dodge because of increased defense through Amrita Absorption and Kasha because of faster movement speed through Amrita Absorption. Kasha is also fantastic Yokai ability that almost always puts Scorched status on the enemy. Secondary Guardian Spirit I went with is Hyokucho because of Anima Charge through active skill and more healing with each elixir used, but it is entirely up to you which secondary Guardian Spirit should be active. Skills we want from Switchglaive are from low stance for starters. Kiboshi Kicker is amazing against humans and quite good against Yokai as well. Skyward and Calamitous Blade are both fine additions. Now we need the right side of the tree. path of the tree is great, and all switch stance upgrades too. It requires practice to utilize them effectively, but it isn't terribly difficult. Next, we have two Mystic Arts. If you thought this build is OP as hell already, wait till you unlock Mystic Arts. By using switch stance moves, you are given a buff that goes up to number 5. Hold quick attack button to activate insanely powerful skill afterwards for massive damage. Besides these active skills, get the blue node upgrades. From Omnio we need Protection, Extraction, Weakness, Barrier, but only until last Guardian Spirit bonus called Faster Key Recovery through Amrita Absorption becomes active, Sloth, Incantation Mastery, and two Elemental Familiars. I use Water and Lightning. Before familiars are unlocked, use any other elemental spells. Purification Talisman is a must too. From ninjutsu, only Poison Shurhand, Shurhand Shooter and Ninja Tool Mastery are needed. Clan we want is Takenaka as always. So how to play this build? As always, we start with Elemental Stop Talisman, which one depends on the boss we are facing. Then we use Protection, Extraction, Barrier, start the fight, cast Sloth, Weakness and poison the enemy with Shurhands. Lastly, we cast familiar spell of element best suited for the occasion. If fighting yokai bosses, then use Purification Talisman 2 on the weapon. Versus humans, corruption is better. If your Amrita gauge is not full, use couple of spirit stones to fill it up. That way Golden Gourd increased damage through Amrita gauge is at its peak. Now to explain what is happening and why this build is so OP. Familiar spell applies elemental debuff, same like every other elemental spell. On top of that we apply purity or corruption status. By applying two different elements, confusion debuff is created. This debuff slows the enemy, reduces defense and increases key damage they take. It is most powerful debuff in the game. Low stance is best for applying debuffs through weapon attacks because it can deliver many attacks quickly. I generally use Kiboshi Kicker combo and it works really well. Extraction Talisman does wonders for this build. By extracting Amrita, we get increased attack bonus from Golden Gourd, increased defense through Shoot and Dodge Soul Core, increased movement speed through Kasha Soul Core, and life recovery through Amrita absorption from Chest Piece. After Yumehami Guardian Spirit last bonus has been activated, faster key recovery through Amrita absorption is added to the list as well. Just remember not to use Barrier with it, because those two bonuses do not stack. When it comes to attacks and which active skills to focus on, I would advise low stance skills I have mentioned in skills section before acquiring Mystic Arts. On top of that, practice during fights stance switch combo, so when Mystic Arts are unlocked, you won't have issues getting 5 stacks of Mystic Art bonus to release that insane attack. Don't forget that when switching realms, confusion and other debuffs disappear, so you're gonna have to apply them again. Also reapply barrier on yourself and cast familiar spell when enemies lose confusion status. That would be all for this one. Thank you for watching and enjoy.
やるわね。負けないわよ。